The Wake, an evening of musical tributes for Professor Olufolabi Olumide, was held on Wednesday, the 27th of January, 2021 at the Musan Center, Unikan, Lagos. Professor Olufolabi Olumide was a Nigerian academic, a distinguished gastrointestinal surgeon, a foremost educator, an enthusiastic musician, and a poet. He was the pioneer vice-chancellor of the Lagos State University, LASU, a position he held from 1983 to 1988. His career in medicine spanned over 50 years, with stints in several countries in Africa, Europe, North America, and Asia, particularly in Saudi Arabia. Professor Olufolabi Olumide began his educational journey in 1940 at CMS Primary School. He attended Igbobi College, Lagos, and proceeded to study medicine at the University College Ibadan on scholarship. He then moved to McGill University, Canada, to continue his quest for knowledge, and then Saudi Arabia, before he finally came back to Nigeria. Known as an academia per excellence, Professor Olufolabi Olumide is the author of the book, If I Had Wings. He was a medical director at the Lagos State University Teaching Hospital. Those who knew Professor Olufolabi Olumide knew that he was a devoted lover of God and music. He was the music director of the Healing Cross Choir before he became the foundation vice chancellor of the Lagos State University. He played the piano excellently well. Professor Olufolabi Olumide was a real family man who is survived by his wife, Mrs. Folashade Olumide, and four children, Dr. Fumi Dahunsi, Dr. Jumoke Oduwole, Mr. Rotimi Olumide, and Mrs. Oyinka Badejo Okunsonya. Professor Olufolabi Olumide passed peacefully at the age of 84. He would be remembered for his phenomenal academic achievements, impeccable pedigree, and character of humility, kindness, and generosity. The Wake, an evening of tribute for Professor Olufolabi Olumide, began with a hymnal rendition titled Through All the Changing Scenes of Life, led by the choir of Cathedral Church of Christ, Marina, Lagos. The service was attended by the immediate past Vice Chancellor of the Lagos State University, Professor Larry Waju Fagbohun, Mr. Bimbo Ashiru, Chief Funlola Okunowo, among other important personalities. The evening of tributes featured presentation of music by Emmanuel Chapel Choir. A stage performance by the Classical Arts Entertainment titled The Story of My Life, and a theatrical performance by the Kalakuta Dance Group.
Congratulations, the procedure is a success.
There were tributes from the Old Boys Association of Igbobi College, friends and family members of Professor Olufolabi Olumide, who all said his demise has left a void that can never be filled. The event ended with a special song rendition by his immediate family members and in-laws. On Thursday, the 28th of January 2021, the Cathedral Church of Christ, Marina, Lagos, played host to family members, friends and well-wishers who gathered to pay their last respects to a fine gentleman and medical surgeon per excellence, the pioneer vice-chancellor of the Lagos State University, LASU, Professor Olufolabi Olumide, who passed on to eternal glory on the 8th of January 2021 at the age of 84. Professor Olufolabi Adedeji Olumide was born in Lagos on the 18th of April 1936 to Mr. Emmanuel Adeoye and Mrs. Agnes Ojo Olagbe Olumide, nee Ajose. Due to his high level of intelligence, after his final exam in secondary school, he was invited by the then principal of Igbobi College, Reverend R.B. Parker, to stay and teach music and other art subjects. The young Olufolabi Adedeji Olumide performed very well before he gained admission to study medicine in Ibadan. Professor Olufolabi Adedeji Olumide carried out extensive research in general surgery, which took him to Denver, Colorado from 1977 to 1978. He was also a prestigious Fulbright scholar in Boston, Massachusetts and Pittsburgh. The late Professor Olufolabi Adedeji Olumide was an outstanding professional. The church service began as the remains of the late Professor Olufolabi Olumide was received into the church amidst the singing of the opening hymn led by the choir of the Church of Christ, Marina, Lagos. The first Bible reading was taken by Babatishe Oduwole, grandson of the deceased, followed by more hymnal renditions.
The first Bible reading is taken from Revelation 21, chapter 21, verse 1 to 7 in the NIV version. And it says, "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." He said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life. Those who are victorious will inherit all this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." This is the word of the Lord.
Swiftly afterwards, the sermon was delivered by the Archbishop of the province of Kwara and Bishop of Kwara, Most Reverend Dr. Olusegun Adeyemi, who spoke on the spiritual journey which Christians must understand.
Items of facts of life that are difficult to accept. When you get into a church, let's talk about the spiritual journey. When you get to an Orthodox church, Anglican, Methodist, African, the church is so built to remind you of the spiritual journey to which you are obliged as a Christian. Baptism in the Anglican Church and Orthodox churches happen very, very early, and manfully do three things: to fight under the banner of Christ against sin, the world, and the devil, and to continue Christ as the Christ faithful soldier and servant unto his life's end. That servant means Jesus Christ is Lord. The journey continues. To be able to fight the devil, the world, and Satan, you need empowerment of the power of the Holy Spirit, so they prepare you to know the tenets of Christianity and seek confirmation by the Holy Spirit, which is what prepares them. Like Christ said in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you'll be my witnesses." In other words, those battles that you vowed to fight, you cannot do it in your power. The Holy Spirit needs to empower you. And when that has been done, there are three very important key verses of scripture in chapter 6 of the book of John.
There was the presentation of a special duet rendered by Gushi Kest Ebunine and Bingbe Funsho, after which the church choir and the Chapel of Healing Cross Choir sang a selection of some of the favorite hymns of the deceased. The Lagos State University LASU also honored their own, their founding vice chancellor, by rendering a special citation, while the cathedral past choristers Cathedral Circle, Cathedral Harvesters and Igbobi College Old Boys Association sang songs of tribute in honor of the late Professor Olufolabi Adedeju Olumide, which brought the service to an end. The remains of the late Professor Olufolabi Olumide was later carried to the Ebony Vaults, Ikoyi, Lagos, where he was finally laid to rest. Biscon Communications commiserates with the entire Olumide family. May the soul of Professor Olufolabi Olumide, the outstanding father of the Lagos State University, rest in perfect peace. Amen.